Hi guys, crisp on the outside, soft on the inside. A very tasty aloo paratha recipe is what I have for you here. Start by using 2 1/4 cups of atta or whole wheat flour. Add some salt, 2-3 drops of oil, mix it well, and then using water, make a soft but pliable dough. A tip here is that by the time you finish making the dough, the vessel should also appear clean without any traces of dry flour. We are now going to rest it for about 15 minutes. For the stuffing, I'm going to use 2 big russet potatoes, good enough to make 8 parathas. Peel it first and then mash it. If they are slightly hard, you can also microwave it again for about 2-3 minutes. Let's add the spices now. Add 1 teaspoon cumin seeds, 1/2 teaspoon ajwain, 1 heaping teaspoon of coriander powder, 3-4 teaspoon of amchur powder, about 1/2 teaspoon red chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon turmeric powder. We also like cracked black pepper powder in our paratha. Add some grated ginger, about 1 teaspoon, and 2 teaspoons of green chilies. Then you're going to add some salt and a handful of chopped dhania. If you don't have dhania, you can also use kasuri methi. Give this a good mix so that all the spices blend together. This is what we need. By this time, the dough has also finished resting. We are now going to make small balls out of the dough and then give it a round shape. To be precise, make 8 small balls out of the dough. I have reserved some for later. Using flour, start rolling the ball into a small circular disc, good enough to hold the stuffing. The key point here is that with every bite of the paratha, you should be getting the potato mixture and not just atta. So be generous with the potato mixture. Close this properly so that it helps in the rolling process without letting the stuffing ooze out and make it harder for rolling. This also emphasizes why it was important to have properly mashed potatoes without any chunks, because then it makes the rolling process easier. See this? This is what we need. Now we are going to roll it without putting too much pressure on any one side. You may use some dry flour to help aid the rolling process. For crisp parathas, start with medium-high flame, use some oil and then put the rolled paratha on the tawa. Drizzle some oil on the top. You're going to let it cook on this side until bubbles develop. See, these are the ones that you see. Now flip the paratha and then drizzle some oil again for those crispier edges. Again, let it cook on this side. You'll see that the paratha starts puffing up. You're going to flip sides and then cook the paratha until you get the desired texture. The paratha looks nice and ready. We are going to remove it off the tawa and then apply some ghee for that extra nice flavor. Serve the paratha with some yogurt and pickle. If you like this recipe, let me know in the comment section. Stay fit, stay happy. Until next time, take care.